eternal God, the creator of heaven and earth. Father, here we are tonight in humble submission and adoration to your name. We give you thanks and glory for the wondrous works thou have done in our life. Thou who separated us from our mother's womb. Thou who gave us this word to be a light on our path, to guide us through all the journey of life until we see you face to face. My Lord, my God, may your name be praised. We bring sacrifice of praise unto your name. We magnify your name tonight. I know thou hast made a way for us. You called us your bride. Most precious Lord, the words in the English dictionary is not enough for me to show thanksgiving tonight. For you have done mighty work, Lord Jesus. For just leading me to the land of Africa in a pandemic era where a very sick mother that could barely raise her head, and I will saw me through with the prayers of my brothers and sisters, Lord. And I'm back here, Lord Jesus. Oh, thank you with them, Lord. Knowing fully well that whatever is left of this journey, it's always in your hand. If we live or die, it is in your hand. How grateful are we, and how thankful are we. My Lord, my God, take glory tonight. As we come tonight, Lord, to share the word, to go into prayer, may you be with us, Lord. May you give us a word tonight that will increase our faith to run this race with mastery, like the one that wanted to win. If it's not for you, where shall we go? As Peter declared, where shall we go? You are the bread of life. You are the eternal life. You are the everlasting Father. You are the Prince of Peace. You are the Yahweh. You are the Lily of the Valley. You are the Prime Minister. You are everything to us. May your name be glorified. My precious Lord, I bring to you tonight. You sing among us, Lord Jesus. My mother-in-law asked for prayer tonight. May you go and touch her in that place of need. May you minister to her soul. And every brother, every sister that is here tonight, my precious Lord, I thank you for them. I thank you for the Son of God. Thank you for the Patrick. Thank you for the Anthony. Thank you for Sister Solomon. Thank you for all my sisters, all my brother, my children, my wife, my Lord, my God. Those who couldn't make it, may you be with them. Father in heaven, I am here, Lord Jesus. I'm not in my hand that pain, but I don't pay the birth, and you can feed me tonight. I'm praying on you, Lord Jesus. Oh, blessed be thy holy name. Blessed be thy holy name. Father, Sister Joyce is in your hand. Sister Veronica is in your hand. Sister Zoe, my Lord. Sister Rose. Sister Solomon. All my precious sisters, Lord. Holding the fabric of the family together, Lord. Precious Lord, may you minister to our soul tonight. I am depending on you, my Lord. My peace is in your hand. My life is in your hand. May this message, Lord Jesus, that you've given unto us, may always burn our hearts. Oh, Lord Jesus, taking away every impurity, purifying us, Lord, for you cancel us the light, Lord, as tried by fire, for your name's sake. May your name be glorified tonight. I pray with thanksgiving in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Maybe be on your seat for 5 minutes or so. I know it's prayer meeting. Of anyone who is online, I greet each and every one of you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I bring you greetings from Africa. It truly was a blessing to have taken this trip. It's totally different when I'm sitting, I don't see my mother sitting there. It's a different feeling I have to get used to. It's the first time I've been to service without her being there for the last 15 years. But the Lord prepared this trip, and the devil did everything he can do to frustrate me at every corner. You didn't know I was in New Jersey on the day I was supposed to be flying. But Patrick, I called him, I said, I'm boarding the flight. That was September 17th. We were sitting in the flight, ready to go, except the plane had a problem. One of the engines is not working. If we had taken off, it's a different story. We are right at the tarmac, about to go, and the pilot said, I'm sorry to announce, I'm not getting signal in one of the engines. And I had just said my final prayer. I said, Lord, I'm still in your hand. We sat on the tarmac for another hour, and then they said, well, you can leave the plane now. We're going to put you in a hotel in Newark. They put us at Hilton Hotel in Newark. Oh my, you should see myself and my mother in one room. And I have to take care of everything you can imagine. And I kept praying, saying, Lord, this is the final stretch. You know, when you're running a race, you're about to finish the race, and it's just the final stretch. And devil was doing everything. By the way, friends, we got to the airport. The lady looked at my mother and said, she's not flying. We can't fly her in this condition. That's the first thing. We can't fly her. I said, who says so? She said, the airline policy. She sits on a wheelchair. She can't sit up. Say, we cannot fly her. It's health hazard. You have to have a letter from the doctor. You have to go home and come tomorrow. I said, I'm not going home. I said, look me in the face. I'm not going home. She said, well, you're going to have to talk to the general manager. I said, call the general manager. Ethiopian airline. They called the general manager. The man came out. I said, sir, look me in the face. He said, I'm not going home. I'm flying tonight. The man said, you're not flying. I said, I'm flying. I said, look me in the eyes again. I said, I'm flying tonight. Brother, you can't stop me. I'm flying tonight. So he said, well, I said, give me one condition. Just one condition. He said, I give you one condition. She has to get off from this seat. She has to walk down the hall and walk back. If she can do that, then she can fly. I said, okay. I said, mommy, get off of that chair. She got up. I said, walk. She started walking. I said, walk down. She walked all the way. I said, walk back. She walked back. The man looked at me and said, she's flying. I said, thank you. Amen. Amen. Friends, remember I always tell you, there is a time to pray. There's a time to act. That trip will be indelible in my heart. For the Lord showed me at every step, he's there. It's not easy, but he's there. He's there. The trip took longer time than anyone imagined. People were rioting on the plane. Because the plane has to go from Newark to Togo, supposed to go from Togo to Nigeria. No. They say there's no flight from Togo to Nigeria. It has to go from Togo back to Ethiopia. And you have to stay there 2 days. And on the third day, then the flight will go to Nigeria. But I'm patient. I said, all I know is that at some point, I'm going to be in Nigeria with my mother. That's all I know. Even if it takes a week, I'm okay. I'm settled. I've settled with the Lord. I am going. So friends, we got to Togo. The Nigerians on the flight begin to riot. They say, this flight will not go from Togo to Ethiopia. It must go from Togo to Nigeria. Because from Togo to Nigeria is about 2 hours. But from Togo to Ethiopia is another 6 hours. They say, so why are we flying backwards? They say, it's because of their logistics. No flight is supposed to come to Nigeria. So they look at me, they say, are you not a Nigerian? I say, yes. They say, get up and riot with us. I say, no, I'm not going to riot. I'm a minister. And moreover, look at my mother. I've been holding her head for the last flight. She can't even put her head down. I've been putting her head up. Her head is coming down, literally with my hand. I say, no, I can't. I'm so tired. But I don't have to clean her because she cannot use the bathroom. It was something else. So they rioted and everything, and they were told, well, they have to leave the plane. They make a deal with them. They have to stay in Togo. And the next day, a flight will take them to Abuja, Nigeria. For me, I said, I'm going to Ethiopia. That was my plan. I'm not leaving here. So when they left the plane, they told them they have to take another test for coronavirus. They have to take a fresh test in Togo. So they ran back to the plane. They said, no. Because if they say, if you take the test in Togo, they might give you coronavirus in Togo. So they all ran, because they don't know when they can leave. They can be stuck for a week. It was something else. And that's how we ended up in Ethiopia. They put us in a hotel. When the military guarded the hotel, you cannot leave the hotel room because you're in transit. And because of pandemic, you're not allowed to leave the hotel. So a military man was literally walking in my hallway. I came out, was the man warned me, said, get into your room with his gun. I said, oh my friends, at some point I just said, Lord, I've done everything I can, you know. I'm weak, but I was strong, you know. And then he always gives that subtle, I am with you. He encouraged me, and I read the book of Psalm for 2 days while in the hotel room to keep me company. The book of Psalm kept me going for 2 days. And then on the third day, we flew to Lagos and continued from there. So friends, your prayer kept me going, and it was wonderful when I got there. Every morning we had fellowship. Every morning I have fellowship. About 2 hour fellowship every morning, and the one I sent was one of them. The one on Sunday, where I called, you know, the community to come so we can pray and cleanse the land, because I know the land is dirty. Amen. 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 You know, when Joshua got to the promised land, you know, the Bible tells us that according to the scripture, wherever your feet tread upon now belongs to you. So as a child of God, I have to claim that land. Amen. I have to chase out every voodoo on that land, amen? Because we are not afraid of voodoo. Glory, hallelujah! Because we have something stronger than any work of man, amen? With all the idol worshiping, man. You know, sometimes it's good when you go to a place. You know, Brother Patrick and I were talking, you know, go visit a church. And sometimes it's good, go visit the people. You understand what I'm saying to you now? It's easier for me to have gone there, going to a church where I know there are a couple of believers and just preach and go home. But it was better for me to be in the community where the people are still stumbling, they are blind, and show them some light. Amen? And they can see their contrast. They can see why you're different. You see now? You see, you go to them to show them why you're different. You know, I went to their church with them because I went for a funeral and it was in a church, and I stood up and I told them, I used to be in this church. I grew up in this church, but I'm not part of it anymore. Hallelujah. And they looked at me and said, I'm no longer part of you because I have something that you don't have. Hallelujah. And they all look at me like, who is this man? That's right. You have to show them a contrast. Why would you put a light under the table? If you know you have a light, let the world see. Amen. And people start coming for prayer. People were coming every morning, coming for prayer. Say, I need prayer. I am sick. I need that. You know, and you're praying for them. And you're telling them about the message. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To me, it was fulfilling. It's a good way to spend my time. Hallelujah. As again, just going to a church and just sit in the pulpit like I'm here. I can do that when I come back here. Amen. But when I go out there, it's needful to go to the community, go to places where they don't know much about the message, and show them their contrast. Show them why what you have is different. Show them why they are still blind. We don't hate the people. Hallelujah. That's part of the message tonight. We don't hate no one. See, the prophet taught me, and he taught you very well. We hate organization, but we don't hate the people. That's right. We don't hate people that go to Catholic. We hate Catholic organization. Because some of the people that go to Catholic, they are as good as me and you. Hallelujah. That's the message. But they are in our organization. You see now, you know better than they have known. But they are still good people there. And that's what Abraham taught us. So when you understand that, it helps to minister very well to the people. You can connect with the people. Hallelujah. So the minute you spend with them is valuable time. Hallelujah. So I consider that a good way to spend my time. And I'm happy to be back here with you. Hallelujah. And your prayer kept me going, because I know you were praying. I know you were singing. Hallelujah. And I can feel the anointing where I am, because the Lord is leading the way. But the world is confused, my people. This is a very terrible time in the world today. When you go out there, you see how terrible it is. It is terrible. People are scared. People are afraid. It is terrible. Even to fly back from Nigeria, you have to be tested for coronavirus. People are scared. Nobody's doing anything. Flights are not allowed to even come in. I have to buy 2 flight tickets to come back here. My first flight is not allowed to come in. There's no European airline going to Nigeria. You have to cancel your flight and get another one. I have to buy Qatar airline. Hallelujah. So people don't know what to do. There's some element of uncertainty. Hallelujah. But you know something? And I believe this with all my heart. And something ministers to my soul about this. It was during the time of scarcity. It was during the time of famine that the house of Jacob was blessed. Hallelujah. The house of Jacob was blessed during the time of famine. And we are the spiritual Jacob, for we are the spiritual Israel. For Jacob is Israel. Hallelujah. During the time of famine, that's when Joseph was recognized. That's when Joseph brought his brothers to Egypt. That's when Jacob came to Egypt, during the time of famine. Hallelujah. And these are the days of famine, both physical and spiritual. Both happen at the same time. Before you can say we are in spiritual famine, because the world has so rich, but now the riches of the world is diminishing. So there's also physical famine today. Hallelujah. And we will be blessed regardless. Hallelujah. Do you believe that? Let's be on our feet. Tonight, before we go into prayer, we're going to share a word on how we restore, say the Lord. We're going to start from the book of Joel. The prophet preached that message, I will restore. He preached that message 6 times. But 2 of them, one is in New York, one is in Arizona. That's we're going to pick from the one in Arizona, I believe, 1957. I will restore. So sisters, you can preach on the side, because we're going to read certain things from there. It is March 9, 1957, I will restore. The first scripture we're going to read will be Joel chapter 1, from 3 to 4. It is a time of restoration. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's read the book of Joel chapter 1 from 3 to 4. Can you get the scripture? Joel 1, 3 to 4. Tell your children of it. Let your children tell their children. And let their children another generation. That which the Pama worm had left, had the locust eaten. And that which the locust had left, had the canker worms eaten. And that with the cankerworm had left, had the caterpillar eaten. Now let's go to 2:25. It's the same scripture that our prophet used to preach all of the same messages, connecting both, and I will restore to you the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworms, the caterpillar, pepperworm, my great army which I sent among you. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen. You may have your seats. So before we go into prayer, let's just share a few words on restoration. Now, the message of the hour, we know it's complete. Why is it complete? Because the mystery of God is finished. Amen. The message that you have received is a complete message. When we're talking about restoration here, Proverbs is connecting it first from these insects. These four insects is actually the same insects, but it's different form. So the first thing that it was, which you know you have read, it was first a pepperworm. And as a pepperworm, the characteristics was to eat the fruit. And that fruit he was eating is what the prophet typed to be love. Amen? Amen? And when you look at the characteristics of this worm, you also have to type it a little bit to the seals. Perhaps you have not seen it that way. When you go to the first four seals, you notice that the seals is also the same beast, the same devil. That's right, the changing color. From the first horse rider, which was a white horse rider, and from white, it turned itself to red and black and pale. But it is the same horse rider, it's the same devil. It's changing form. So when you look at the book of Joel, referencing the insects, the prophet told us, and it is true, it is the same insects in a different form. First it appears, it was just a pepperworm. From a pepperworm, it becomes a locust. And from a locust, it becomes a cankerworm. And from cankerworm, it becomes a caterpillar. But it's the same insects. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! And Joel, the prophet, he foresaw, hallelujah, with the gift of prophecy given to him, he foresaw, he looked on the higher side, and he saw the day of Pentecost. And because Joel saw the day of Pentecost, he began to reference him in 2:25. I will restore. Hallelujah. And somehow Peter, on that day of Pentecost, when he stood that day, he was able to see afar what Joel had seen. Because Joel has prophesied, I will restore, saith the Lord. And on the day of Pentecost, Peter was able to stand there and say, this is now which Joel has written. I will restore. And so now Peter is typing the experience of Pentecost with the book of Joel. Because the prophecy had to do itself. He had to tie itself. God is not the author of confusion. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if the same horse rider is changing color, we can recognize that horse rider. We know who he is. We know exactly what he's doing. And that's why as a believer, you cannot be moved. Hallelujah. He might change color, but we know who's riding him. We know his end. We know his objective. Hallelujah. The first objective was to come to the church age. It is to take away the love. So the first fruit was love. And the prophet talked about even the gift of the Spirit. That the first gift of the Spirit is wisdom. And before you have wisdom, you must have the fear of the Lord. Because the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And you know the second gift of the Spirit is knowledge. But before you can have knowledge, you must have wisdom. And this insect knew that if he can attack the very love, the heart core of God, for God is love, if he can attack love, and diminish the love that we can have for one another, the love we have for God, therefore the fruit is bad. Hallelujah. is attacking the love of God that God has for man. He is attacking you to show you that God does not love you, that you're on your own, that whatever happens to you, God doesn't care. And that's why in the first church age, God told them to go back to your first love. Hallelujah. Because love was in danger. And Jesus Christ said that they will know that you are part of me when you have loved one for another. And that is the hardcore of Christianity. It's the agape love of God. If you can manifest that love, then the restoration has begun. God couldn't start restoration without bringing back love. Hallelujah. He said, I will restore what that instead of even the power war. He came to attack love. And because he came to attack love, and the love of man was cold. A man thinks now of himself, doesn't think God is the God of love. That God is the creator that thinks of you. That you are in his hand. There's nothing you can do without him. You have to depend on him solely. And devil is a copycat. He begins to tell you you're your own. He will tell you that all these denominations, that there's nothing left. Look at the denomination. Look at what I've done. And the prophet said, if he's putting an idol worshiping, because that's what they have done. They made an idol of the creature because of denomination. They made a non-image of God because of denomination. They call him Trinity because of denomination. And Nicaea Council, they changed the very doctrine of God to become Trinity. Hallelujah. But because you know who you serve, I'm praying that someday by his grace, maybe we get to something on Sunday. I try to title it the vindicated instrument of worship. Because this is making me to remember that each time I'm speaking. The vindicated instrument of worship. You see, my brothers and sisters, if you don't understand who you are and what God brought you through, you will never know where you're going. This incense is very troublesome. As you travel the world, as you see churches, as you see blindness, then you truly know what incense have done. But God said, I will restore. What is he trying to do? Restoration is to bring back the original position. It is not to replace. Hallelujah. 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 God is restoring. He's bringing back for a purpose. Because there is a place that God has appointed for you and I to dwell. And that place is here on this earth. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And this earth has to receive a fire baptism as the restoration period is still going on. Hallelujah. And it's until you get to the sixth seal. You see, six is the number of man. Man was created on the sixth day. Hallelujah. He had to take the sixth seal to clean this earth again. Hallelujah. He had to take the sixth seal to clean this earth. And after this earth is cleaned on the sixth day, then we are coming back. Hallelujah. And that's still the process of restoration. 6 days to create man. 6 days, the sixth seal. The sixth seal will clean this earth. Hallelujah. If this earth is not clean, then the habitation of the bride and the bridegroom is not still in place. It is the process of restoration that will bring it to form the way it was before the failure. Hallelujah. So the insects are eating. The power worm is eating the fruit. And here come the locusts. After the worm has been eaten, the locust is coming to eat the leaves of the tree. And the leaf is fellowship. Friends, that's why whatever you are, if you have not come to the point of fellowship, you need prayer. Hallelujah. Any brother that tells you that you don't need to go to fellowship no more, that brother needs prayer. Because the very essence of who I am, as we see on Sunday, if there be a Sunday, I am an instrument of fellowship. Hallelujah. For this purpose I made, is to worship him. Hallelujah. Not for no other purpose, for this purpose I made. Therefore, if you don't get that revelation, you need some prayer. Hallelujah. That's what the locust ate. Prophet gave an example of a tree. You know, when you see a tree with a very good leaves, what does the animals do? Well, the birds, they come under the tree for shade. You know, and you as a human being too, when it's so sunny out there, looking for a tree that you can go under the tree for shade. Hallelujah. hallelujah, to protect you from the atmosphere, protect you from the sun. It's for protection. And that's what fellowship is. Hallelujah. In one accord, you worship God. In one accord, you bring down the Holy Ghost. In fellowship, hallelujah. And they love one another even unto death in fellowship. Hallelujah. Because God is restoring back. When the love of God is restored, it's followed by fellowship. Hallelujah. And that's the very essence of what the pepper worms is doing. Pepper worms ate the fruit. Now the locust is finishing the leaves. And after the leaves of the tree has been eaten, what is left now? You have the bark of the tree and the root of the tree. And the bark of the tree represents sound doctrine. Hallelujah. Sound doctrine. And the mother said, if all that God demanded was just sacrifice, then the Moab is equally as sacrificial as Israel. Is that right? Is that right? Because when Balaam told Balaam to come and curse Israel, in the book of Numbers, he told him to come and curse Israel. In Numbers 23, they made an agreement. He said, let me consult God. He said, now, and when Balaam consulted God, God told him, don't go. But then Balaam knew that if he can speak to Balak about the sacrifice of Israel, perhaps that God can change his mind. And so Balaam told Balak, build me 7 altar. Bring me 7 ram. Bring me 7 bullock. And this is exactly how Israel worships. That's how Israel sacrifices. Israel will build 7 altar. They will bring the 7 ram. They will bring the 7 bullock. They will sacrifice each ram to each altar. Hallelujah. When they finish it, then God will come down. See now, so Balaam knew that. But what Balaam failed to understand is that Israel has pillar of fire. Hallelujah. The pillar of fire is the vindication of where God is. And that's why an instrument of worship, if your worship is not acceptable, it's not vindicated. You have a vindicated message. Somebody asks you, why do you believe this message? It's vindicated. In other words, God put a stamp on it. Hallelujah. The sacrifice of Boaz was not vindicated because the pillar of fire didn't come down. And if sacrifice is all that God demanded, then Cain is what is sacrificial. For Cain was also sacrificing. But Cain was sacrificing without revelation. Hallelujah. Cain was sacrificing without revelation. And that's why his sacrifice was not accepted by God. And this sound doctrine is what the cankerworms have eaten. Hallelujah. So people sacrifice their God, they don't know. They worship their God, they don't know. They make the word of God of no effect. And that's why, my brothers and sisters, when you go to certain denomination, you just have to pray for the people. You don't hate no one. You don't call no one name. And this very message, if people try to make it a dogma, if people try to make it a denomination, that pattern will fail because you cannot denominate this message. Hallelujah. For we know by the church ages, and when the church head of Luther became a denomination, the pillar of fire left. Hallelujah. And when Wesley came on board, and the Wesleyan message became denominated by Methodist, the pillar of fire left. Hallelujah. And this message will follow the second coming of Christ, and therefore will never be denominated. Never be denominated. Men may try, and they will fail. Because there will be a people who will refuse to follow the denomination. There will be a people who have received the pillar of fire and they are moving by the fire and nothing will turn them back. There will be a people who recognize who they are. There will be a people who are not moved by no trial. There will be a people who will stand the test of time. Hallelujah! Until we see the Lord face to face. And I believe those people are here tonight. If you are here, say amen. Say amen. Bless every name of the living God. You can never denominate this message. Because each time the move of God is there, people denominate it. What do? They select a man to be the head. And when they do that, pillar of fire draws back. For only God can lead his church. That's why in the church ages, God said, I hate the spirit of denomination. I hate the Nicolaitan spirit. Nicolaitan, not the laity. Hallelujah. And he was acting on the church ages. And God said, I hate that spirit. And I hate the promise of Balaam. God said, I hate that Balaam doctrine. Balaam doctrine is seduction. Doctrine to seduce. Hallelujah. He came to seduce the people of Israel by offering the same seven lamb, seven altar. And the people of Israel were seduced into idolatry. And God said, I hate that spirit. And these are what the incense have eaten. But God said, I will restore, saith the Lord. Hallelujah. And when the incense thought it was all over, then here comes the caterpillar. Caterpillar is just to take away. It's just to put those. A caterpillar, see how it sounds? Caterpillar, just to take away. Even the name of it, cankerworm. Think about it, cankerworm. If you attack a cankerworm, can you stand? Hallelujah. Think about the name of this incense. Even their name is so dominating. You are attacked by cankerworm and caterpillar. But God said, I will restore. Hallelujah. Why? Because according to Matthew 42, he said, there will be a people, 24:24. Matthew 24:24. If it's possible, the elect will deceive. But it's not possible. It's not possible. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can shake the tree. You can shake the leaf. You can shake the bark. But there are some people who will stand by the root. And God begin to restore back. Hallelujah. That's why Peter stood that day of Pentecost. Said, this is that which is written by John. And look at Peter, uneducated. He's not a scribe. He's not a Pharisee. He's not a Sadducee. He's not a Sanhedrin. Uneducated. But he's the one quoting the scripture. He's fulfilling the book of John. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And while I travel, I met a man who told me he loved the message so much, but he wants to go to a Bible school. He wants to go to a Bible school. I said, have I not told you my prophet never went to high school? Have I not told you about him? What do you think we see in Bible school? Can the blind lead the blind? Hallelujah! You see, man, they have their understanding. Perhaps, if you go to a good Bible school, you get a theology degree, you get a respect of the people. That's what people are looking for. Hallelujah. But friends, that's death. Hallelujah. For we know by revelation, our prophet didn't even go to high school. And that's who God chose to reveal his word to. Like Peter, he never went to high school, can't write his name. That's who God chose on the day of Pentecost. Hallelujah. And Paul, despite his knowledge, God doesn't need his knowledge. Hallelujah. He wiped off his knowledge. And Moses, despite his knowledge, God doesn't need that. He wiped it out to set their feet upon a solid rock. Hallelujah. And this day, you and I might be a nobody. Hallelujah. But we are somebody in his presence. I might be a nobody for the world, but I'm somebody in his presence. Hallelujah. For he's watching over his sparrow. He said, I will restore, and I believe his word. It is the age of restoration. Whatsoever the cankerworms are meeting, whatsoever the cankerworms are meeting, whatsoever the locusts are meeting, he said, I will restore. Hallelujah. The restoration of the bright tree is back. The bright tree is restored. Hallelujah. The tree of life is restored. Hallelujah. And that's what we're feasting on. You're feasting on the body world. And as you're eating the world, you're becoming the world. Hallelujah. And as you become the world, you become the living world. You can call them that are not as though they are. Hallelujah. You can look devil in the face of the devil. You can do me no harm. Because I am in the Lord. And the Lord is in me. Hallelujah. He promised to be me. And me and he are one. We can never be separated. What can separate us from the love of Christ Jesus? He's restored back to the bride. Hallelujah. The bride is restored by the word of God. By revelation, you know who you are. When the bride gets to know who she is, she will do greater things. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the living God. Do you love him tonight? Do you love him tonight? Look, in 1 Corinthians 12, the gifts of the scripture, the gifts of the spirit, the prophet laid emphasis on that, from wisdom, to knowledge, to faith, to healing, to miracle, to prophecy, and discerning of the spirit, and speaking in tongue, and interpretation of tongue. 9 gifts, according to 1 Corinthians 12, from 4 to 10. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah. And all these gifts, all of them have been restored. Hallelujah. Because God is a God of honor. When he said, I will restore, he means what he's saying. Hallelujah. And look at the nine fruits of the Spirit as fruits of the Spirit. Galatians chapter 5 from 22 to 23. They have the fruits of the Spirit. Hallelujah. And there are also nine fruits. So there are nine gifts. There are nine fruits as well. Hallelujah. The nine fruits are there. You start with love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, meekness, hallelujah, and temperance. Nine fruit of the Spirit, nine gift of the Spirit. I will restore, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know I am restored. Are you restored in him? Are you found in him? It's no longer me or you. It is Christ in us, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. The process of restoration has begun. I will never stop until we cross the sixth seal, and I will not be here. Hallelujah. Because this earth will be restored. Hallelujah. Right now, this earth is corrupt. It is corrupt. The atmosphere is corrupt. The environment is corrupt. Everything about this earth is corrupt. Hallelujah. And devil is the one that's corrupting it. And devil is the one that's king of this earth. Then one glorious day, according to the seal 6, he will come the day of Armageddon, and he will unleash the armies of God to fight devil once and for all and liberate his earth, and he will come with fire. Hallelujah. Baptism of fire. This earth has seen baptism of water. The fire is coming upon it. One glorious day. That's what I'm waiting for. Hallelujah. And I will not rest until it's restored fully. Hallelujah. But right now, my brothers and sisters, you have to keep eating the word, waiting, because even if you fall asleep, when this earth is restored, you are going to come back again. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the living God. I was talking to a brother. He called me while I was in Ethiopia. He was calling me about a brother that passed away. He said, Brother Paul, he was calling Brother Serge. He said, Brother Paul, I'm trying to reach Brother Serge. I've been calling him. Did you hear from him? I said, Brother, Brother Serge died a month ago. I was in his funeral. He said, nobody told him. He said, nobody told me. And he said, you know what? He said, Brother Serge called him about a week ago before he passed away. And Brother Serge told him, he said, Brother, I think I'm going home. He asked him, where is home? He said, I think I'm going home. I think I'm leaving this earth. He said, but pray for me. That when I live peaceful. I don't want to suffer. See? He called his brother and requested his prayer. And this brother didn't know he passed away. So I'm telling him, I said, Brother, so God answered his request. Because he went to sleep on Friday and he woke up on Saturday. And you didn't even know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see how God can answer a request from a brother to a brother. Hallelujah. Friends, there's nothing to be scared of in this world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're not praying to die soon. But even if one were to eat this my flesh, God said, I will restore. Hallelujah. Friends, we believe the message of restoration. The message is complete. The revelation of the world is for you to realize that you've been restored. Because you are in a fallen estate. Hallelujah. You are in a fallen estate. We are born in sin. We are shaped in liberty. There's nothing good. We are in a fallen estate. But if you're being restored, hallelujah, you're being taken back to the original position. Hallelujah. If the love of God is in your heart, hallelujah, then you are restored. Because the love of God makes you equal to God. Hallelujah. If the love of God is in your heart, then you are an amateur God. The prophet told us how he used love to conquer every obstacle. A bull was attacking him as he was crossing the yard. In the same message, he gave the testimony. How the bull was coming. He said, but what made me to tell this bull to sit on the corner was love. He said it was love. What made him to tell the peace that was attacking him was love. You see, now with love. And the prophet said, you want to know the secret of the message he's preaching is love. He said, you want to know the secret of the healing ministry is love. Hallelujah. Therefore, love will conquer every sin. Hallelujah. If we can have the love of God in our heart, my brothers and sisters, that's the mystery. That's the secret to success. Hallelujah. Because the first thing the instant it was love. And that's why the first church is said by love. The church end of Ephesus, God said, go back to your first love. Hallelujah. Because the love of God was waxing cold. And that's where the fall began. And God is restoring back. Hallelujah. Put the love of God in your heart. Put the love of God in your heart. Say, I love you, Lord. They say, I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. They say, I love you, Lord. Say, I love you, Lord. Say, I love you, Lord. Hallelujah. Prophet said here in the message, I will restore 57:09, I believe it is, line 10. In our religious belief, we find the same thing. We find that some people one thing and some another. We find some believe one thing and some another. But we always try to make it a policy to never try to cross up anybody. Do not do anything wrong. When I come out of the Baptist church, I never went across the country telling what a bad bunch of people the Baptists are. I go across the country telling what a fine bunch of people the Baptists are. Because they are. I might not agree with them just on everything, but I certainly will take one of them before I will take an unbeliever. Before I will take a communist, as long as they are mentioning the name of the Lord, though I wouldn't believe with them, I certainly. We might not believe on every principle, but we believe on Christ. And that's the main thing. Hallelujah. I wouldn't mean to speak evil of the Baptists or the Presbyterian or the Catholics, because they are Catholic people who I believe are saved. Amen. They are Catholic people who I believe they are saved. Hallelujah. So we're not attacking people. When we preach against the denomination, it's the system. Hallelujah. Because the system is seducing. It's Balaam doctrine, not the people. Hallelujah. There are nice people in all the denomination. I mean, when I travel home, everybody has seen most of them there. Go to one denomination or the other. A bunch of nice people. Hallelujah. Whatever you need from them, they will give you. But they are sincerely wrong in their doctrine. Hallelujah. But you got to love them. It's a tough love, right? You got to love them. Hallelujah. See, and that's many of them. See, I wouldn't believe the system of Catholic, but I believe in the Catholic people. I don't believe in the system. Hallelujah. You believe that too? You don't have to go to church with everyone. Some people may go to a different church, you don't hit no one. Hallelujah. Just because they don't come to church with you doesn't mean they're not your brothers. Hallelujah. There are four things here that I want to mention, say the prophet. He said here, that is Joel, the prophet, who was God's eagle, who climbed up into the sphere of God and saw the day coming. Peter quoted him on that day of Pentecost, Joel 2:38. He said, this is it which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And Joel saw the coming. And if the Joel's prophecy was so accurate that he saw Pentecost many hundred years before it even happened, then surely the prophecy that he has given to this day, we will say, will be accurate. But the thing I want to speak on is this, the four great destroyers. Prophet is talking about those insects. The first was the palmer worm, the locust, and the cankerworm, and the caterpillar. Hallelujah. We are told that it is the same insect. It's just different form coming down. Hallelujah. If the Pentecost was God's fine, which was the new wine that was growing up, then the fourth destroyer has been in the one that's the same vine down. Now let's find out what Pentecost had. First was God lacking, and then we ought to find out what the destroyer are. Who are they? Well, let's find them. Now the first thing that the Pentecost produced was brotherly love. Amen. Brotherly love. It tore it down in the middle wall to partition them, to make brotherly love to such a way that they had everything in common, according to the Bible. Brotherhood. Paul spoke of brotherhood, that he gave all the gift of Pentecostal church, and then said in the First Corinthians 13, that though I speak with tongues of men and angels, and I have not this love which brings the brotherhood, I am nothing. And though I have the knowledge to understand all the mysteries of God, I am still nothing without love, the love of the brethren. Amen. And Jesus said, this will all men know that you are my disciples, when you have love one for another. Pentecost had that. And speaking of Pentecost, the first group of apostles, they had that brotherly love. They wasn't greedy. They sold everything they had, fighting for the church. They were so together to even when one had the other died, they said, let's go and die with him. Such a feeling. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you have such feeling in your heart? Do you have it in your heart? Friends, we must have that. Hallelujah. When you hear that one is suffering, it is you suffering. If you can pray for somebody to be healed, that is the secret. You must feel the person's pain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you cannot put yourself in somebody's shoe, you better off not praying for them. You just make it nice. Hallelujah. For the prayer to be effective, you must be sincere. Remember, that was the commission given to our prophet. If you're sincere, what does it mean? If you really love them, if you're sincere, it's not a put up or make up. To be sincere means to be real. If you really love them, if you are sincere, and you pray, and you get them to believe you, then nothing can stand before you. But you've got to be sincere. Hallelujah. It cannot be a lip service. You see now? You cannot say because he's there. And when he's not there, you say whatever you want to say. Or because the sister is there, you speak nice of her. When she's not there, you say whatever you want to say. That will not work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You got to be sincere. You got to have the real love in your heart. You got to feel their pain. You got to feel like it's your pain. And then you can pray. And then God will answer your prayer. Hallelujah. Are we together? Blessed be the name of the living God. Thank you, Jesus. The first was the primary war, the logos. Hallelujah. See now, the other war is nothing but brotherhood. Finish eating it. Hallelujah. The time is pressing. We are going to prayer. I want to give more time to prayer, you know. And here the prophet said, now Jesus spoke of this. Paul did and said, brotherly love continued. That was the first church where something had taken place. And there was a fellow come by the name of Pamawon. And when he began to eat that fine brotherhood love, he cut the very sap line out of it, because it don't make any difference how smart we are, how much we think we know, or how much we want to be different from somebody else. And as long as that brotherly feeling isn't among us, we are fighting a losing battle. Hallelujah. It doesn't matter how much we think we know. As long as the brotherly love is not among us, we are fighting a losing battle. My God, that's right. We cannot win. There's no way for us to win. Hallelujah. I will restore, saith the Lord. The first thing the Lord will restore in your life is that love. So if you don't have love in your heart tonight, may you pray and say, Lord, I'm in the process of restoration. For I know this earth will still be restored, for this earth is still corrupt. And I'm a product from this earth, because I was taken from this earth. Hallelujah. You were taken from this earth. As long as this earth is not restored back, you are still in the process. But if you have the love of God in you, you are ready. You are sealed. Hallelujah. You are sealed. You are ready. So that when the roll call is called up yonder, you will answer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There's one more thing here. Now, on line 19, it says here, Now, the next great thing come up was the locust. He was one that was to destroy the unity of the believers. See, fellowship, unity of believers. That's what the locust destroyed. In the Bible, in Pentecost, there was a unity. And these people were with one heart, with one accord. Paul said, I believe in Romans 7, the 7th chapter, there's nothing could separate us from the love of Christ Jesus. The 8th chapter of Romans, of love of God, and that's in Christ Jesus. There was nothing. Hallelujah. So we see now, after the leaves are taken out, now the locust is coming there now. What is locust doing now? Locust is destroying the unity. See, when the church is not together, when the church of God cannot bind himself, remember, whatsoever we bind on earth is bind in heaven. You can only bind them in unity of faith. Hallelujah. So the church is not pressing on, church is not moving, because the church is not together. Hallelujah. And when the church is together, you see the church moving in one accord. You see the power, you see the anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I believe it's not about the number, it's not about how many, it's about the unity of faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So as we come together in one accord, let us press on together. Let us press on as a faith, as a unit, as one accord. Hallelujah. Moving in the same direction. Because how can two agree except they are? How can two move together except they agree? How? Hallelujah. How can we press on and say we agree? Hallelujah. And I believe the fabric of Christianity is among us. I see that love among you. I see that unity of faith. I see that love that encourages me. Hallelujah. It helps me to keep pressing on. Hallelujah. May we never lose focus on that. It's the most important, friends. It's not about a number. It's not about a number. Hallelujah. Jesus. There's one more here. Just close it so we can pray. Start there. Let me go to the last quotation here. Our prophet said here about 9:39 or so. He said, prophet said here, is there any hope then? What hope? Is there any hope, you say? But Abraham, is there any hope? Blessed be to God. Say, blessed be to God. I will restore, saith the Lord, all the years, the blessings that the cankerworms, the caterpillar, the permaworms, and everything else are within them, and brethren, as a middle-aged man, as a preacher of the gospel, as your brother, which loves you with Christian love, I am looking to see the day soon when those cankerworms and caterpillar will be sprayed with God's incense powder. And every church will embrace one another. Men shall be brethren and praise the Lord. Amen. Let us be on our feet. Hallelujah. I will restore, saith the Lord. Tonight, search your life and see where you have gaps. Look deep within and see what needs to be rebuilt. Remember, before Elijah could offer a sacrifice, he rebuilt the altar. We realize that although Moab built 7 altars, but they don't have pillar of fire. We have a vindicated message. Pillar of fire came down, never went back up again. He stayed with the bride. That's why the message is vindicated. Tonight, whatsoever you desire, deep in your heart, don't let your heart condemn you. If there's any God found in you, tonight, make it right first. And then present it before the throne of mercy. And we're serving a God of restoration. He made a promise, and he will keep it tonight. As you go into prayer, open up your heart, pour out your heart before the Lord. Ask him to fill you back up. Any place there's gap, whatsoever you desire, that will help you in this course of this life. He's there to give it to you tonight. If you are a brother, a sister, a relative who you know, perhaps they don't have the revelation that you have received, they need prayer. They don't need to condemn them, you need to pray. If you know of your friend who is yet to know Christ to the power of his resurrection, you need to pray for them tonight. What you have received is vindicated. As you go into prayer, begin to pray. Begin to call him on the scene. Pray. Begin to call him on the scene. Sweet hour of prayer. Play sweet hour of prayer, son. Sweet hour of prayer. Sweet hour of prayer. It is sweet hour of prayer. Call him on the scene. Peter, by revelation, declared, "This is that which is written by Joel. I will restore, saith the Lord." Yes, we know the insects came. They began to eat the very love that was manifested at the day of Pentecost. And the prophet in the whole church ages laid it out. And it was at Nicaea Council that they began to lay a doctrine as contrary to Jesus Christ. He told us how he went to Rome and saw a picture that depicted God the Father, depicted God the Son, and God the Father was a man with a big beard, and God the Son was a little boy, and depicted the Holy Ghost to be some kind of a bird flying around. What a picture of dogma. Causing God to be angry. But he declared, "I will restore the animal." He sent me a prophet to restore. Restore the integrity of the Godhead. Bring back the position of sonship. Bring back the position to be a child of God. Be back to Godhead and to his children. Establish the kingdom of God on earth. And the message is vindicated. Never for once did God fail to come on the scene. And so, tonight, may you identify yourself with the spirit of the message. Times are hard. Pandemic era, yes, it is true. But I'm serving a God of restoration. He didn't care. It was a time of famine. He established Joseph. He had to take famine for Joseph to be established. But if he has no famine, then why do you need the mouthpiece of God? He had to take this moment to establish the bride. When the world is confused, there has to be a people who know their God. They will do their exploit. When the world is in turmoil, there has to be a people who understood and read by the book. Like Daniel, he read by the book. He recognized his day. He's living in. Yes. We read the message. We heard the message. Recognize, saw. What time is it, saw? Saw. Is it the end? Saw. Oh, my Lord. El Shaddai. I call you and say to my Lord, God of restoration, restore to me the joy of my salvation. Restore to the bride the joy of our salvation. Oh my God. Yes, my Lord. Yes, my Lord. That the locusts have eaten. Yes, my Lord. The pomegranates have eaten. Yes, my Lord. The cankerworms have eaten. Yes, my Lord. The caterpillars have eaten. Restore the love of God in our heart. Restore the fellowship of the saints. Restore sound doctrine. And restore godliness. Godhead. Position of Christ in the church. Position of Christ in the church. He is the Lord. He is God. He is the Alpha. He is the Omega. As a Father, He created. As a Son, He redeemed. As the Holy Ghost, He dwells. And so be it. For your name's sake, hallelujah, my Heavenly Father, the word I will preach, but don't break it up, but it's still your word that was given to us by the mouth of our prophet. May you put it together, Lord, and bless the heart of the believers. To everyone who heard your voice tonight, voice of God for our day, may do something to their life. May wash them whiter than snow. Most precious Lord, I give you glory tonight. I give you honor tonight. I praise your holy name. And the church of the living God, purchase of your blood, and let us be contending for the same faith that was once delivered to our Father. And let us be contending for the same faith that gave the message of the hour. And let us be contending for the same faith that will cause rapture. And let us be contending for the same faith. Oh, that will destroy every work of demon, every devilish power, every fetish power, be it on the earth, be it upon the earth. This faith of God Jesus will destroy them. It is the same faith that we have. Faith of Paul has, the faith that Peter has, faith of Timothy, faith of Stephen, the faith that William Mary of Prayer has, in the faith of the saints. Oh my Lord, my God, may you give us that faith to stand the test of time. For your name's sake, blessed be the name of the living God. Holy is the name of Jesus. What is the Lamb that died for us? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! He shed his blood on Calvary, and he declared it is finished. He said, come unto me, O ye that labor and heavy laden. Oh, his yoke is easy. Most precious Lord, my life is in your hand. Remember my mother-in-law. She asked for prayer. Mrs. Edna Oyoyo. She called me tonight to request prayer. Her body is under attack by the enemy. Her body against Lord Jesus. Who made the body in the first place? Who made us on her? It is you. It is you. I speak shalom to her body. I speak shalom in the name of Jesus. May the peace of Christ Jesus passes all understanding. Come under that vessel. Be a vessel of honor. For your name's sake, most precious Lord, this church of the living God, my brothers and sisters, that are your hand, my Lord, may the hand of Christ Jesus be upon each and every one of you. May whatsoever you desire from him be your portion in the land of the living. May you walk like the saints of old. May you call the things that are not as though they are. May your faith rise up to claim whatsoever you desire from me. But Jesus, your church is in your hand as we are waiting for your coming, Lord. Oh, Jesus, my Lord, thank you. Thank you for victory. Thank you for victory. Thank you for victory. Thank you for victory. Thank you for sanity of our minds. Thank you for peace of our minds. Thank you for healing our soul. Thank you for healing our body. Thank you for healing our spirit. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for full restoration. For the message of the hour is full restoration. Thank you, my Lord. Blessed be your holy name. The Adonai, the great Adonai, Jehovah the Steady, Jehovah the Nisi, the I am that I am. It is you, and your name is Jesus Christ, the name above all name. On this name, every knee must bow, every tongue must confess, Jesus Christ. He is the Lord. Father, thank you for my wife. Thank you for her friendship. Thank you for moral support. Thank you for her labor. Thank you for my children. Thank you for preserving them. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for the family of my precious brother Patrick, his wife and children. Thank you, Lord, for the family. Brother Solomon, his wife and children, Brother Anthony, my Lord, and the most precious wife, and the little ones, Brother Juan and family, most precious Lord, the fabrics of our faith, our fellowship here, thou who have preserved us. Remember, Sister Marilyn, Lord. Lord Jesus, upon the infallible word of God, upon the authority of the word of the Lord Jesus, we speak shalom to her body. We bring peace to that vessel, to conform to the image of the living God, to be a vessel of honor. We bring shalom to that body. In the name of Jesus Christ, it's established. Mighty Jesus. Remember, the family of Barashanak in South Africa. About a priest when I sent me the image of a very bad accident. Our brother is doing mighty work in South Africa. Does a lot of tent service. He's been here. I've been with him here. And now we heard his son-in-law passed away. His daughter passed away. I don't know whether his wife passed away, but I know he's in a bad condition. The motor accident claimed almost all his family in South Africa. My Lord, he's your servant. He has preached this message for more than 40 years with scars to show. And I know it's not in vain. For you say it in the scripture, oh, glorious is the departure of the saints. Glorious in thy sight. My Lord, accept the souls of the departed. Let them be in fellowship with the saints. Precious Lord. Oh, Father. Your name be praised. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Remember Brother Pedro? Brother Gessler? Brother Sayeth? Father, I dedicate them unto you. Be with them wherever they might be, whatever they are doing at this hour. Brother Sylvester, all those who have stepped their feet here, they are precious in my heart. I love them all. For once in fellowship, is always in fellowship. My heart will always rejoice for being in fellowship with each and every one. And every church you have let us be part of, we bless each and every one of them in the name of Jesus Christ. From West Orange to Elizabeth to Georgia to Africa, wherever the saints are gathered, Lord Jesus, may you be with them. May you strengthen them for this journey of life. And if you tarry to come, Lord, help us to run this race until the end. For you are the bread of life. Father, if there's any sin found in us, if there's any iniquity, Lord, we present it before thee, that it be blotted out. And when you look down, red upon red becomes white, whiter than snow. My precious Lord, may you help us where we make a living, in our jobs, in the things we do to make a living. I present it to you, my Lord, for it is needful that we are still on this vessel. For Apostle Paul, let us know, for us to live is Christ, for us to die is gain. Therefore, as we live, may you help us. Even as we make a living, may you help us. May you subdue the land for us, that we will till the earth, it will yield fruit, for your name's sake. Oh Lord Jesus, thank you for my mother back in Africa. Be with her there, and be with my people there that are helping her. Oh Lord Jesus, everything is in your hand, my Lord. We thank you for who you are. The mighty Jesus, the mighty conqueror. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Father, I commit this prayer into your hand. I thank you for this hour of prayer. The fervent prayers of the saints, the prayers of agreement, prayers of oneness, prayers of togetherness, prayers of one accord, thou will accept. With thanksgiving we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.